This is St. Anthony the Great, the father of monasticism. St. Anthony was beyond virtuous, but today we will focus on his obedience to God and his will. St. Anthony's life began like many privileged people, with two parents and a loving, stable family. So, how did this normal upbringing lead to his sainthood? Well, for starters, he was born in Upper Egypt at around 251 AD to two wealthy yet God-fearing parents who taught Anthony and his sister to love the church and the poor. When St. Anthony was about 20 years old, his parents passed away, leaving him to care for his sister. Shortly after their death, St. Anthony went to church, and his life completely changed upon hearing the words of Christ in the Holy Gospel. While attending the service that day, he heard the deacon read Christ's command, "If you want to be perfect, go, sell what you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasures in heaven, and come, follow me." Because of St. Anthony's obedience, he took his command personally and did exactly that. He returned home, sold all his belongings to the needy, and placed his younger sister in the care of a group of virgins. There were no established monasteries at this time, so St. Anthony went off into the wilderness to fulfill his calling for an ascetic, solitary life. During his time in the desert, the devil constantly opposed St. Anthony's holiness, attacking him with feelings of boredom, laziness, and images of women. Nonetheless, St. Anthony had faith in the power of Christ and prayed for strength. When the devil saw St. Anthony's diligent and intense worship, he would become so envious that he would try and hurt him. He sent demons in the form of wolves to beat St. Anthony. But St. Anthony believed in the power of God and was not discouraged. Whenever the devil tempted or hurt him, he sang the psalm, "Let God arise, let his enemies be scattered, let those also who hate him flee before him." After struggling in the wilderness for a period of time, St. Anthony wished to become a martyr, to be persecuted for the sake of Christ, especially when he heard of the persecution that was going on in Alexandria, Egypt. While traveling to Alexandria for the hope to die for the sake of Christ, in his wait, he ministered to his brothers and sisters who were imprisoned for their faith. The governor saw St. Anthony ministering and became angry. How dare someone publicly declare their belief in Jesus Christ? The governor ordered St. Anthony not to show up in the city. But St. Anthony did not fear the governor, so he went into the city in the hopes of the governor becoming so angry with him that he would torture St. Anthony. But God recognized St. Anthony's potential and the blessings he could bestow over many, so it was not in his will to have St. Anthony become a martyr. In St. Anthony's obedience, he abided and returned to the mountain, where he would establish a monastery. While continuing to live in solitude, St. Anthony was frequently tempted by boredom, which led to confusion and discouragement. He frequently prayed to the Lord, "Lord, I want to be saved, but these bad thoughts do not leave me alone. What shall I do? How can I be saved?" An angel of the Lord appeared to him in response to his prayer, showing him how he ought to combat his boredom. The angel was in a cycle of weaving palm leaves and praying, and he said, "Anthony, do this and you will rest." And he did exactly this and was never bored again, thus showing the blessings of obedience. St. Anthony's fame spread throughout the land, and Emperor Constantine heard of St. Anthony's ascetic worship. He thus wrote him a letter asking for his blessing and prayer. However, St. Anthony did not accept or want the emperor's praise. Nonetheless, St. Anthony's friends reassured him of Constantine's love of God, and he later replied to him with a letter praying for the peace and safety of the empire and the church. He listened to his friends, obeying and trusting in all humility. St. Anthony had many saintly friends, like St. Macarius and St. Athanasius. Together, they helped pave the way for the monastic lifestyle we see in Egypt today and in other parts of the world. St. Anthony overcame many trials by the power of prayer, providing a model for Christians to follow. When the day came that St. Anthony felt himself leaving the world, he commanded his disciples to hide his body and to give his staff to St. Macarius, and to give one sheepskin cloak to St. Athanasius, and the other sheepskin cloak to Anba Serapon, his disciple. He stretched himself on the ground and gave up his spirit. After about 105 years on earth, St. Anthony departed to the Paradise of Joy in 355 AD. May we mirror his obedience with his prayers, and glory be to our God. Amen.